G'day everyone, how's it going? My name is Clayton, this is the Planet Canada channel, and welcome back to another Cabinet Vision tutorial. The tutorial today is going to talk about how we can create our own custom handles or pulls in Cabinet Vision. We'll go through the process step by step, and we'll try and make it as beginner friendly for you as possible. We'll also show you how you can import your own SketchUp files or your own SketchUp models into these pulls to be used in your future project. So let's get into it. Any new pull is a new material, and any new material begins in the material manager. So we're going to click on the material button at the top here. So I reckon you've probably already got a folder dedicated to your pulls or multiple folders because it's important to keep a handle on it. But if you need to create a new group, on the top left here, you can see I can click on the create group button. It'll add a new folder. Then you could just rename it to be whatever you'd like, or just call it pull 2, for example. And then I can use these arrows to toggle between the different levels and start arranging this folder structure. So we're going to delete that. Now we basically have two options to create a new handle here. We can either click on the new button at the top here and follow the prompts to create a pull from scratch, or we can copy a pre-existing handle, which is already similar enough. Most of the settings are the same, perhaps. Maybe the model's identical. It just needs to be tweaked a little bit. And then we can finish off the changes so that it's ready. I would say often when you can copy and just tweak the existing pull, usually that's the fastest way to do it because you don't have to worry about all the different settings. However, it's quite simple and efficient to do it with a new pull as well. We'll look at both of them. So if I click on new, you'll notice also that this is the exact same process for all the other materials in our material manager. So we want to create a new pull. And we'll just call it the test pull so that we know what we're dealing with. Now, Cabinet Vision is going to ask me a handful of questions like the unit of issue. So because it's a handle, we want it by each. And we have to choose here a 3D model for Cabinet Vision to use. So we don't have to commit to this model. We can change it later on in the process. But at this point in time, we have to choose one of the defaults. So I say often choose the pull or the model which is already close enough to what we're trying to create in principle. So we're going to go with pull number one. Now, I like to fill out this information in metric because a lot of the handles follow the rule of 32. So I'm going to go with 160 mil from center to center. The good thing is that Cabinet Vision will give you these little images on the side here to make sure you understand 100% what value this needs to be and what it represents. Any single manufacturer or any single seller of a handle that we're purchasing for a job probably has all of this information readily available on that order page. There's probably a section for the specifications. So usually I would just search them out, open them up, and then fill in the information here according to that. So then once we're happy with this info and we can click through, you can also change the finish type and the texture, and then we click on finish. Equally, we could find, say, a handle which is already similar. We can click on copy, and then we can just do the exact same thing that we've just done. But here, we scroll across these different settings at the top here and make any of the changes we need to make in these fields. So we're happy as Larry, all the different settings are configured for our pull. It's nearly ready for our Cabinet Vision jobs. But let's say we now would like to import our own 3D model to be used for this pull in our Cabinet Vision jobs. Or maybe we're happy enough with the default pull model that's in our current material, but we just like to edit it slightly, maybe stretch it a bit or change its placement. To do that, I'm going to double click on the ID number, and this is the material properties for this specific handle, and that corresponds to all these different settings in these columns you see at the top here. So you could equally open up and make those changes. But if we want to modify the model, I'm going to click on the model button. Cabinet Vision opens up the model editor for this handle. So if I click on 3D mode, Cabinet Vision gives me a 3D view of the model. So this can be useful for giving you a good feel for how this model is going to look in your future Cabinet Vision projects, especially after you're finished making your modification. On the left-hand side here, you'll see I have three different models that are working in tandem to be one. I have the two shafts and the pull, which make up this handle. Now, I can click on these models. I can change, for instance, their positioning on the XYZ axis. So let's move this bottom shaft on the Y axis. Let's add 2 inches, and you'll notice it's come up 2 inches, and I can just remove that here. I could also click on any of my models and change the DX, DY, DZ value, essentially stretching the model myself in cabinet vision. But if I have a very detail orientated model, then I could risk maybe disfiguring, deforming this model a little bit by stretching it too much. However, simple shapes like we see here work really well with this stretching tool. So you could use this exact same model and just keep stretching out the pull itself to the different sizes you need. But let's say I don't want this handle at all. I would like to use a handle I've already created, maybe myself in SketchUp, or I've downloaded from another website online. So to demonstrate how, I've just quickly drawn up a super simple pull, and there's a couple of things we'll note. Firstly, when it comes to installing models in Cabinet Vision, the simpler the better. The more detailed a model is, the more polygon counts there are in this model, it can risk demanding greater performance from your computer. And especially if your computer isn't equipped to handle such great detail, it can potentially slow down your experience of cabinet vision, which we don't want. So there is a fine balance to strike of a detailed enough pull that it really elevates the quality of your cabinet vision drawings, without being so detailed, so realistic that you have to sacrifice performance in your computer and your cabinet vision to generate it. That's just something to keep in mind. And also, cabinet vision at the moment accepts SketchUp 2020 files. So when I go to save my SketchUp file, I just make sure that it's saved with this SketchUp 2020 extension, like so. But once we're happy with the file that we'd like to import, I'm going to click on the primary work plane, and I need to be in one of these views here. So I'm going to click on the front view, and then I can click on the add hardware button. And here I can find my SketchUp file and click open. And Cabinet Vision gives me a little preview, and it asks me to clarify some important details before it imports this model. So for instance, I can flip the different axis that this will come in at. I can also scale it, and it also gives me an idea of the complexity of this model with the poly count. The less a poly count is, the easier and quicker it will be for Cabinet Vision and your computer to generate. But once I'm happy with that, I'll click on OK, and you'll notice that Cabinet Vision has brought my model in. So the advantage to keeping the old model in as well as the new model is I can use the old model as a bit of a guide before I remove it and delete those parts. So at the moment, I can see that my pull handle, I know that's the right one because that matches the tag that was used in SketchUp. This needs to come over on the X axis by about 8 mil. So we're going to click on -8, and that's going to bring him over. Fantastic. And I'm going to drop it down as well. This is where you can use, for instance, the measuring tool if you wanted to get it spot on. Or you could also click at these points here to drag it and get it close. And then you can fiddle around with these dimensions to make it really precise. So once you've made the modifications here and you're happy with the model and where it's placed, we can remove the old one. To do that, I'm just going to click on each of these different elements here. And then I can right click and click delete, or I could click on it and also click remove from this view as well. And that will give me the same option for the pull until all that's left is the pull I have created and imported. Fantastic. So now we're ready for the final step. So before any pull or any material is ready to be used in our Cabinet Vision projects, it needs to be added to a schedule. So I'm going to click return. We're going to save this. That was test pull, the first one we created. So we're going to click return again. Then I click on material schedules, and then I want to find my pull schedule. So I'll click on that, and I could just create new, and then here I can give it a name, and Cabinet Vision is going to ask me to drag from this menu here, the library of all my materials, the right material I would like to use in this schedule for my doors, drawers, and finger pulls. So if you wanted to, you could also find, for instance, a similar schedule that already has this information filled out, make a copy of that. It's a little less important for your pulls because there's only three options, but for your assemblies, it's definitely a good habit to be in. Then when we go to our schedule, I'll just find it on the right-hand side, the test pull one. I can click, drag it across. And then if you really need to, you can also rotate your pulls as their default. So at the moment, having both of these no means that for my doors, this pull will come in by default vertically. And for my drawers, this pull will come in by default horizontally. So 9 times out of 10, you probably don't need to change anything here. We can click return. We can open up a new job and you'll see that our new test pull schedule is ready for us to use in our project. Hardware, pull schedule, and there we go. I just opened up a job so that I could finish off this video and show you how great these pulls look in my kitchen. However, I've realized I've made a little error, and that's okay. I thought I would show you what it was anyway in case you run into this same issue. Clearly, as I was filling out the dimensions for this pull, I didn't put in the right vertical inset. So to fix that, it's really simple. And if you ever see this same kind of behavior issue with your pulls, it's probably that setting to fix. So I'm going to close this job down. I'm going to open up my material manager again and find that pull that we've fixed. And if I just toggle to millimeters, you'll see that I've put in a 50 millimeter vertical inset, which if we compare it with some of these other pulls, which definitely work, that's very far from the mark. So all I need to do is make the change here, but because I've already saved my project with these handles in it, I need to update the project. So that's a good lesson as well. We're gonna click return. We're gonna open up our job. And then from the plan or elevation view, I click on utilities. I click on update job and materials and click okay. And that's just telling Cabinet Vision, I've made a change to the settings of one of the materials you're currently using in this job. Go through, do a recheck and make that adjustment so that now when I click on 3D, there you go. Now the handle looks good. If you have any more questions or would like anything clarified about the process for creating new pulls or any other materials, please feel free to leave them down in the comments below and we look forward to seeing you in the next video.